Hi, I'm Gordon Wallace. I'm the director of the Intelligent Polymer Research Institute and a research scientist on the bioengineered cornea project here at the University of Wollongong. Our first challenge, of course, was to mimic that stroma layer, that intermediate layer that's the most complex. So we have created that structure on the bench, and now we have to look at how we can actually build scalable, manufacturable approaches to creating the bioengineered cornea. We can take one donated cornea, extract the cells from that, proliferate those cells to create more so that we can make multiple synthetic or bioengineered cornea.
The printing process begins with creating a blueprint using a computer software. And then we load the blueprint in the printer, and then we isolate the cells out of the human tissue and combine it with our biomaterials to get a bioink, which acts as an ink for the printer, and precisely depositing the bioink layer by layer and creating a corneal identical to the digital model we created.
The amazing network that the Organ Tissue and Donation Service brings, if we can make this, they already have in place the means to deploy it and to get it out to patients. We've been working in this field of bioengineering for decades, and it really has been the vision to ensure translation. So we're hoping, so within a handful of years, that we would be getting set up to do the first in-human trial.
Although there are many challenges, I would say this is my dream. I want to develop something to can really relieve the pain of the patients who are suffering from corneal blindness, which can be used in corneal transplantation in the next 5-10 years.
This will be the first manufacturing line, let's call it, for a bioengineered product. If we can do it for the cornea, we can do it for lots of things. It's the first example, right? We can see this turning into many different bioengineered products if we can prove success in this one.